There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Great location, history, workforce, innovation. Is that what you think of when you hear the words Wheeling, West Virginia? Well, here's the real legacy of Wheeling. We were the first gateway to the West. We became a hub of the Industrial Revolution. We helped build the steel industry on our river, the coal industry in our hills. We became a haven for business innovation and some of the wealthiest business developers on the planet. Wheeling, West Virginia helped move the country forward. And what about now? There's a new Wheeling, one that's inviting to new and growing companies and creating jobs. It's a whole new approach, an innovative transition from an industrial-centered economy to one that brings together the best in low-overhead economic development, one that's attracting businesses with a global reach, creating new offices out of structures long forgotten, building a new energy sector revolution, and a thriving high-tech hub. A city that has turned a declining riverfront into a vibrant landmark. Building resorts and parks on iconic areas while maintaining historic integrity. Developing empty hillsides, lots, and fields into retail, educational, and healthcare destinations. Reducing tax burdens, nurturing both small and large businesses. Once again, Wheeling is innovating, transforming, and most of all, inviting the world to live, work, and play in one of the safest cities in the U.S. What is it about this Wheeling metro area that's so inviting? Take a moment and explore. Wheeling does offer a pro-business environment, but also a pleasing blend of history, culture, fine dining. Metropolitan features found both here and in our neighboring cities. Outdoor recreation, and annual festivals, all guaranteed to provide you with true American hospitality. Wheeling is a riverfront city where the bluegrass meets jazz, blues, rock, and our own symphony. We are the heart of a vibrant metropolitan tri-state area with neighboring Ohio and Pennsylvania, a region of over more than 200,000 people, making us culturally alive and diverse. Located on the I-70 corridor between Pittsburgh and Columbus, Wheeling is home to a safe, comfortable lifestyle with big city amenities not found in most small towns, including Broadway shows and the historic Capitol Theater. That's why so many are saying we offer more. More accessibility, more centralized location, more cost savings for business, more fun with museums, shopping, nightlife, and a huge music scene. More restaurants, offering everything from our own brand of fish and our own style of pizza, to great local eateries and fine gourmet dining. More development and growth, a revitalized riverfront, unique shopping at our center market, and the Highlands. State-of-the-art government buildings, global operations centers, casinos, resorts, more technology, more excellent schools. More excellent healthcare, more sports, like our own pro hockey team, the Wheeling Nailers, and a short ride to the Pittsburgh Steelers, Penguins, and Pirates. And to top it off, Wheeling is more appealing, recognized as one of the most livable small metros in the country. It all adds up to an energetic and welcoming city. Modern, progressive, and moving forward again. So now you know. Go ahead, enjoy the Wheeling Metro. Move yourself or a business here. Find a site and start or grow a company here. Explore our excellent funding sources and tax incentives. Learn about our business resources and live in the comfort, safety, and low-cost environment right here in the center of America. Wheeling, a city that's growing, transforming, innovating, inviting, and a city dedicated to making things happen for you. I'm John Corbett, and Wheeling is the place I call home.
there are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Washington, Maryland, business management.
Pat Mose, Springfield, Virginia, business.
Tim Goff, from Burton, Ohio, marketing.
Sam Peduto, Swickley, Pennsylvania, education.
Christopher Canton, Baltimore, Maryland, sports management.
Mark Winters, New Martinsville, West Virginia, business.
Steve Bridgman, Lancaster, Ohio, education.
Chase Lawson, Sardinia, Ohio, engineering.
Charles Barn, Richwood, West Virginia, business finance.
Aaron Ditterman, Smithsonian, Maryland, accounting.
Nick Williams, Sandusky, Ohio, biology.
Desi Wiseman, Waldorf, Maryland, engineering.
Moo Young Lim, Mendon, Utah, marketing.
Justin Fritz, Mentor, Ohio, finance.
Jordan Fair, Columbus, Ohio, communication studies.
Ewa Heisman, Baltimore, Maryland, business.
Kyle Ritz, Cambridge, Ohio, engineering.
My name is Eric Seifert. I'm from Reynoldsburg, Ohio. My major is business finance.
Matt Stewart, Pittsburgh, engineering.
TJ Payne, Richmond, Virginia, pre-med.
Joe Peduto, Swickley, Pennsylvania, accounting.
Welcome back to the McDonough Center for game number two. Fairmont State Falcons are in town. They come with a record of 7-5, 4-2 in the conference. Jesuit Cardinals 6-4, 2-3, and coming off a recent Southern swing there, Reese, where they split 1-1 on the road, lost to a quality Conquer team by only 4 points. So Cardinals eager to get the new year started.
Eager to get going. That trip they went on, right? Lost Patrick Muse along the way down there with a separated shoulder. Going to be out tonight. Played real well against Virginia Wise, 26 points. From what I understand, was had a dominating performance there, so we're fortunate to see him hurt here.
Yeah, real tough break there.
Especially with Fairmont coming to town. You want to be all guns on deck.
Yeah, Fairmont, always a quality team. You know, any year you get a victory against a Fairmont team, you know you've earned it. And we said, come in a little deceptive record, or 7-5, but 4-up, 2-down in the conference. And Jerry Calhoun certainly done an outstanding job in his young career down at Fairmont. And as we say, anytime you line it up against the maroon and white of Fairmont State, you're going to be challenged. So we're just about set for tip-off. As we mentioned, Cardinals a little shorthanded. Mose not in lineup, and that really hurts. You know, his double-figure scoring, not to mention a huge 26-point effort against UVY. Just about set for tip-off here, and as soon as I find my notes here, Reese, we might even get to some starting lineups. Okay, first for the Falcons of Fairmont State, number 0, Nick Carney, 6'8", hails from Cleveland, Ohio. And the next one, number 4, 5'9", out of Harlem, New York, number 4, Shamgod Wells. Wimbush listed as number 20 in the program, but I noticed there he comes out with uniform number 2. He's a 6'7 forward guard out of Lorain, Ohio, Thomas Wimbush. And number 21, Jamel Morris, a 6'4 guard out of Gahanna, Ohio. And last from Charlotte, North Carolina, 6'1 guard, number 30, Caleb Davis. Fairmont is coached by former West Virginia University assistant Jared Calhoun in his second year. For the Jesuit Cardinals, they'll go with a starting lineup of 6'2 freshman from Fort Washington, Maryland. Number one, Drake Goddard. The 6'8 junior from Burton High, number three, Timmy Goff. 6'1 junior from Mentor High, number 22, Justin Fritz. The 6'7 sophomore from Cambridge, Ohio, number 25, Kyle Ritz. And rounding out the starting lineup, 6'4 junior from Reynoldsburg, Bishop Hartley High School, number 31, Eric Seifert. Of course, the Cardinals are coached by Danny Sencombe, and a long bench on that coaching staff this year.
He's got a whole cast of people over there. It's like one coach for every player.
I'll tell you, some good quality people. Of course, Ryan Coaster's been with us for, what, about 6 years?
Around, yeah, as long as Danny's been here, he's been there.
Of course, a couple of new ones this year. Ben Seifert, the former Cardinal great, along with Adam Vincenzo.
Good St. Vincent's boy. Yeah. Ah, St. Vincent's teacher out there.
So we're just about set for tip-off here tonight. A cold, wintry night in Wheeling, West Virginia. We're right around that zero mark. Wind chill in, what, the low 20s, I think?
Miserable out there.
Minus 20. So good night to come inside, Reese, and play a little bit of basketball.
You got that right. As we can see, students still not back on campus. Coming back this weekend, I believe. Classes start on Monday.
I believe classes start back up on Monday. So we got some music playing. We're trying to get everybody pumped up here, and we're just about set for tip-off. Lady Cardinals were defeated in the first game tonight, led by 13 in first-half action, but Fairmont, quality team, 11-2, come out with a victory. So referee Doug Costain going to step in the center jump circle. He'll toss it nice and high, and we're underway here. Opening tap controlled by Davis. He'll get it to quickly to Shamgod Wells, one of the greater names in the game of basketball. Hails from Harlem, New York. Wimbush.
Right off the bat.
But the rebound comes out, and
Jamal Morris with the quick bucket.
Jamal Morris gets the quick hoop. So
now we're going to see like an extended zone, big one.
I'm
quite sure what it is.
Fairmont will come out after you defensively. We're going to have a quick whistle here early going. Number two, Wimbush, going to pick up the foul. They noticed this past weekend, Eric Seifert struggled a little bit from the field in both games over the weekend, 4-for-15 in both encounters, so he needs to get on track here this evening. Nice ball movement. Fritz.
There's Fritz. He won't struggle. You let him get open his feet set. He's not going
to
struggle at all.
Good to see, and he really looks healthy. We know. Early season, he was just trying to get back into shape. And
get that ankle going. I was talking to him before the game. I said, how's the ankle? He said, well, I think it's fine, but I tweaked the other one a little bit. So keep an eye on him.
So Fairmont with the basketball. Nice skip pass over to Davis. Davis drives in the lane, and Morris gets it. Or that was Wimbush downtown. Rattles around. Cardinals with the basketball, leading by one.
Fritz again. He's
and
hit.
And he's going to be hit for the three-point attempt.
Wells will pick it up, and Fritz will get three free throws out of this.
Certainly one of the Cardinal rules of basketball, Reese. Never foul a jump shooter.
Yeah.
And since the advent of the three-point line, that's even more emphatically stressed by coaches.
Yeah, Fritz with a rare miss at the free throw line.
So Justin with all five of the Cardinals' early points here as they lead by three.
Good to see him involved early, too.
Absolutely. Shamgod Wells over to Davis. Davis trying to look inside. They're going to attack in the low post area.
Wimbush open on the baseline.
Deep three ball by Wells. Long rebound tipped out by Fairmont. Out of bounds, going to be Cardinal basketball.
Yeah. Fairmont really active on the offensive glass. That's a couple balls now we've seen tapped around, so we're going to have to keep an eye on that here.
Yeah, we've seen most of these cats characters last year, and certainly some quick athletic players on this Fairmont State team.
Well, that makes him very effective on the defensive end with that pressure.
And Seifert knocks down a three ball.
Seifert says, I don't know what Tom Beckel's talking about, struggling from the line.
Yeah, that's great to see him with a good start here this evening.
There's Fritz out on a run across. Fritz,
and nice. Oh, nice rejection on the defensive end.
Yeah,
Thomas
absolutely.
Wimbush comes up with a big defensive play.
You know, that's a run where Goff's just got to go strong right at the rim there at his size.
Morris attacks the hoop. Loose ball garnered by Goddard. Goddard in some traffic. Gets it off to Fritz.
Fritz
certainly looking for those offense opportunities. Goddard's going to dial one up from three.
Goddard's going to get one.
Drops it at the bottom of the net. So Cardinals off to an impressive start. It's 11-2. Coach Calhoun will get a timeout.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Back at Jesuit, Cardinals off to a hot start here, 11-2. We're 3 minutes in. Wimbush attacks the basket and
again on the glass, but Ritz able to come up with that loose ball.
Seifert gonna attack the other end. Timmy Goff, three ball.
Oh, just off. I tell you, in and out.
Yeah, that would have been a good one.
And Goddard comes away with the rebound. Jesuit gonna reset here. Fritz Long. So really now with five early three attempts here.
Yeah,
so
missed two on a deep three ball, Jamal Morris, and Fairmont hadn't got the rebounds, but you need to block them out, Reese.
Yeah, you got to get a body on these guys because they are long and athletic and quick off the floor, getting a hand on everything.
Very aggressive on the offensive glass.
And again, we see that pressure, kind of a 1-2-2 press, and then they drop back to a 2-3.
Cardinals, great job of centering the basketball. Ritz. Oh, I thought he'd get that one to fall.
Yeah, great attack there by Fritz off the dribble, and Kyle Ritz going right at the bucket, forcing the action.
Cardinals doing a great job of taking it right at that press and taking advantage.
Did you get a chance to come over and catch any of the cancer research closet?
I only saw 9.5 games, Reese. I missed that. I missed that last half of the first day.
I tell you what, some quality teams in here for that weekend.
Yeah, I heard an interesting story, Reese. They said the one youngster, Carlton Bragg from Villange of St. Joe's, who's an outstanding talent, they said today he announced his college choice. And as he puts on a hat from the University of Kansas, he says he's going to University of Kentucky.
No kidding.
But my understanding is he is going to Kansas.
Okay.
I'm sure that'll
just
be on.
A
if that's
Freudian
true.
Slip.
If that's true, it'll be on YouTube, I'm sure.
I'm going to have to take a look at that. Yeah, I tell you, I stopped over Friday night. Boy, that was some quality basketball played there.
Jamel Morris drives. Nice rebound by Kyle Ritz. And, yeah, the McDonough Center was hopping all weekend.
Fritz
takes
attacking.
It in. Doesn't get the whistle, but gets the basket. So
Fritz is fired up tonight. I have a feeling after that first three, somebody said something to him over there on the Fairmont bench. And
yeah, they did.
He's been fired up ever since.
Yeah, he's come out with a vengeance, attacking the offensive basket. That's Brandon Vega, number one, checked in the Fairmont lineup. And we're going to have a travel, so.
Sure, so right now, 15-2, Wheeling Jesuit on a 15-point run.
Coach Calhoun not real happy there.
Yeah.
Number three, Chase Morgan. Seemed like this guy's been around forever.
I tell you, I think I played against him when he was here.
Absolutely. Senior.
You know what he's coming in the game for, to dial up some long-range shooting.
Yeah, he's a shooter. Cardinals need to get across the timeline. Good job. Timmy Goff back to Eric Seifert.
Seifert had us all fooled.
Going to stay Cardinal basketball.
I'll give the refs credit. Nice job there.
Yeah, that was.
Blew the whistle, said I need help.
Little teamwork.
it could teach the referees in the NFL something.
I hear you, Reese.
Here's Fritz for three. Just off the mark.
Going to be out of bounds to Fairmont. So great start by the Cardinals. Still 15-19 to go in this first half, but Cardinals with a 15-2 advantage.
Yeah. Boy, Fritz keeps getting looks like that. You know, he's a little off on that shot, but you keep giving him those looks, and he's going to find it.
Fairmont going to go with a 1-4-4 low set.
Short.
And one and done once again for Fairmont.
Pass over the
Seaver
top to Goff.
With a long look. Timmy Goff. And he's fouled in the act. Great look by Eric Seifert.
Yeah, it sure was. And that's going to be the second foul on Wimbush.
So we'll head to our first media break. Cardinals on top, 15-2. Wow.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
To McDonough Center. Cardinals off to a great start, 15-2. Timmy Goff going to be at the charity stripe for a pair.
Yeah, Goff going to go to the line and Wimbush to the bench here with two fouls early in this game.
So Goff gets a pair. 15-point Cardinal advantage.
Boy, 17 straight points here. I'd like to say it's great defense. May just be poor shooting here by Fairmont.
Nice little run. Haney with a nice pass inside, and we're going to have the hoop and a little bit of harm.
Yeah, Kyle Ritt's going to be called for the foul, going for the block.
Trevor Andrew Evans, number 24, with the basket.
Foul number 25, Ritz, his first.
Kyle Ritt's going to pick up the foul. First foul on the Cardinals.
24. Andrews Evans.
Can't complete it. Seifert comes out of there with the offense, with the defensive rebound. Oh, nice,
nice
pass.
Nice look. Kyle Ritz was hacked.
Couldn't find the handle. I'm sure he was going to call it at first.
Yeah, couldn't find the handle, but there was a reason.
Yeah, he didn't have a left hand.
Yeah, a little tough with one hand.
So Nick Harney just ended the game. He's going to pick it up.
His first team fifth at the line, number 25, Ritz.
So Ritz gets the first, and Fairmont already saddled with five personal fouls.
Now, Reeling going to bring a little pressure here in full court.
This is Brandon Vega at the controls for the Falcons. So 14-10 on a running clock. Jesuit off to a great start here this evening. Morris going to attack the basket.
Off the mark. Again, Fairmont gets a hand on it, but Reeling able to come away with the rebound. And here comes Seifert.
He's going to take it all the way, and nice job of getting his own rebound. Left hand, Eric Seifert with the basketball.
I tell you what, Fairmont goes after every shot.
And the Cardinals pretty much limit them to one and done, Reese.
Yeah, I tell you, here's Seifert from way outside.
Yeah, Eric was feeling that one.
he's pump faked that one about three times tonight. He finally decided to let it go from about 24 feet just off the mark.
So it's a 17-point Cardinal advantage.
We're only going to play this 2-3 as cold as Fairmont shooting. Probably not a bad idea. Pack it in here, and there we see the turnover.
Nice defensive effort by the Cardinals. Fritz, and
Fritz
he is.
Gets mugged.
Yeah. Manhandled by Chase Morgan.
Gets cross-faced going to the bucket, and he'll go to the line for a pair.
Foul
on Fairmont, so we will be in the bonus from here on out the next 13 minutes.
He's shooting for a long time.
Fritz again, second miss of the night. Guy who averages, what, just under 90% from the line?
Yeah, Cardinals going to go to the bench. Highsmith checks in, and Lawson waiting at the scorer's table.
So Fritz going to get a rest here with 8 points early in this game. Here again, some of that token pressure just kind of forcing the pace on Fairmont.
Davis attacks the hoop. They give you Fairmont a credit. They're aggressive.
I mean, yeah, going to be the second foul on Ritz and checking into the game. Going to be Matt Stewart. I've not seen him play yet this year.
Yeah, Matt has not seen much playing time.
Battled injury that whole first half. Hadn't even dressed it.
Yep.
I think the second game I've seen him dress at home, and the first time around, I don't think he was really ready to play.
Yeah, he's only had 22 minutes all season, so good to see him back on the floor.
Yeah, a kid that started last year as a freshman and finished really strong. Unfortunately, saddled with a little bit of injuries here in the first half of the season, so great to see him back on the floor. Get him back in some game shape.
Yeah, he hates anybody out, but this will give him an opportunity tonight to get some quality minutes. So 16-point Cardinal advantage. Fairmont coming with the heavy pressure. Greg Goddard going to try to beat the press. Cardinal's got a break there.
Yeah. Block call here. Some nice interior passing, and Stewart should go to the line for a 1-1.
So with 12:45 remaining, indeed, the Cardinals are in the bonus. That's about as early as you're going to see it on the collegiate level, Reese.
Well, I tell you what, that was quick.
At the line, number 34, Stewart.
So Matt Stewart nails the first one.
Gets them both. Late substitution here for Wheeling.
Number 5, Chris Canteen, going to check in.
Yeah, Goddard, who gave him some quality minutes here with the start up front. Get a well-deserved break.
Chase Morgan keeping an eye on that guy. He loves the fire. He dribbles in nice penetration, and Caleb Davis going to pick up the easy hoop.
Yeah, nice setup play there. And Lawson, he'll shoot it. Ah. Canteen with the push in the back.
Yeah, we're going to have a little weak side rebound and the foul. So we're exactly at the 12-minute mark, half number one here at the McDonough Center. Cardinals on top, 24-8. Cardinals going to work that 2-3 zone. Vega taking his time left wing.
Travel,
Davis going to be called for the walk.
Cardinals with
He made about four different fakes here before he took a dribble.
Four fakes to go nowhere. Number five, Taiwo Badmus checks in for Fairmont.
Been practicing that one all day, weren't you? Seifert in trouble here, gets it over the top.
Going to
turn into an easy
Lawson
bucket for Chase Lawson.
In.
Not exactly the way you'd draw up your press breaker, but it sure worked.
You'll take the results anytime. So Chase Morgan on the attack for the Fairmont Falcons. Morgan, three ball.
He's a shooter.
Yeah, he's definitely a shooter. We remember him from past years. Can and will shoot.
That's his specialty. Receiver going to attack the rim.
Loose ball and
nice
Cardinals
hands.
Come up with it.
Good shot for Canteen. Boy, and there's Matt Stewart again. He got a hand on the first one. Gets a
very
hand on
active,
this one.
Very active. Vega. Looking to attack, he'll bring it back out front. Badmus, long three and
a nice box out.
Yeah, definitely.
Highsmith in there working hard, puts a body on him and draws a foul on the rebound.
Yeah, Andrew Evans, number 24, over the back, so we'll walk down the court. Cardinals going to shoot some more free throws.
His first teammate.
R.J. Hutcherson, a 6'7 player out of Columbus, Ohio, checks in for the Falcons. Oh.
Highsmith off the back of the iron.
So we're right around the midway point of half number one. Cardinals on top by 15. Certainly have shown the ability to score the basketball this evening.
Fritz snuck back in the game. I didn't even notice. Stewart going to take the offensive foul.
Matt Stewart stepped in, took the contact, and he'll draw the charging foul. And we'll head to our second media timeout. Cardinals on top by 15.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Half action here at Wheeling Jesuit. Tom Barbechtel along with John Respect, Cardinals. Very impressive first 10 minutes of play, 26 points on the board.
Yeah, Wheeling Jesuit, it's, I don't want to say they're not shooting the ball well. They are about 40%. And effective early from the three-point line at 3-for-9, but they started the game 3-for-3 back there. Really got them off to a hot start. Nice job breaking the pressure this time. Back out to Seifert.
Yeah, I like the way Eric backed off that press a little bit. And,
you know, Eric, a guy tall enough to be able to see over some of that pressure and really handle it.
Fairmont going to get the run out here, but
well, credit Matt Stewart hustling down there, and I think he got a piece of that and knocked the layup away.
Highsmith with the easy lay-in. Nice assist by Justin Fritz.
So what looked like an easy two going the other way for Fairmont turns into nothing and 2 points for Wheeling Jesuit.
Yeah, definitely a big change there.
Fairmont's coach shaking his head, Sam. What else could happen?
Well, Coach Calhoun's been looking for combinations. I think they're already about 10 deep on their bench, just trying to find an answer for William Jesuit. Morris.
Oh, wow.
Tough call there.
Boy, sure was. Stewart right there outside the paint. Thought he drew his second offensive charge of the night.
Foul number 34, Stewart.
So Stewart picks up his first. Jamel Morris going to step the line.
At the line, number 21, Morris.
So Davis returns for the Falcons.
We miss them both. Getting that pressure.
Nice job of centering the basketball. Lawson with a skip pass.
Oh.
Yeah, Justin Fritz is going to pick up the foul.
Yeah, Fritz lost it. I thought Stewart came out of it with it.
So the 15 foul on the Cardinals. Fairmont with the basketball, trailing by 16, 8:20 on a rolling clock.
We
always talk about fouling the jump shooter, Reese. That was a fall away three.
Yeah. Yeah, those ones will break your heart.
So Chase Morgan, the senior veteran at the line for the Falcons.
He gets the first two.
I'm trying to figure that one out. He only got two, Reese.
Huh. He's been on the line.
Smith.
The pressure's really picking up here. Matt Stewart does a nice job and attacks. Turnabout's fair play here, huh?
I guess.
Nice job by Stewart looking to attack, and we've seen that. We know he's got that in his game, the ability to put the ball on the deck. Just nice defensive effort.
Foul clearly on Matt Stewart. That's his second. Winner's going to be in the ball game.
Winner's back into the game now. Another guy that battled some injuries here early on.
So a couple of the fresh faces tonight for the Cardinals.
A couple of the big bodies inside. Mark Seifert.
Yeah, we got a foul there. Davis grabs Seifert.
He's going to go to the line for a pair.
That's what you want to see. Put some points on the board with a stop clock.
I tell you what.
Number 30, Davis, his first.
So the 10th team foul on Fairmont. So at the 7:38 mark, we'll be shooting two from here on out.
As aggressive as William Jesuit's been tonight, that could be a lot of free throws here.
So Eric gets the first. So Seifert with a pair. Cardinals back on top by 16.
Nice step and help by Tim Goff, cutting off the drive.
Nice trap by the Cardinals there. Stop the offense of Fairmont.
Nice step and three-point. Nick Carney going to go to the line.
And he'll go to the line to shoot the line.
So Fairmont battling to get back into this one.
Yeah, Fairmont not going to go away. Good team, and you know, although they're down 14 right now, you know, they know this is not unreachable. A lot of time left for Wheeling Jesuit. Got to continue to just run good offense and play good defense here.
Yeah, we're doing a little wardrobe repair, if you will. So Nick Carney all set now, finally ready to shoot. He'll get the three-point play, so 13-point Cardinal advantage. Fairmont going to continue to come with that heavy pressure.
Yeah, and really extended it now, a length of the floor. Not picking up a three-quarter court. Goddard going to get fouled.
Goddard dribbles right into traffic, and he's going to be rewarded with some foul shots. Drake Goddard, the young freshman, going to step the cherry stripe for the Cardinals.
Now the important thing is going to be to make these free throws that we get.
Yeah, you're getting the opportunities. You need to knock them down. Gets the second one.
Now one and two here. We're in Jesuit right around that 80% mark from the free throw line tonight with 18 attempts already.
So Fairmont down by 14. Morris, nice job of entering into the low post, and Carney picks up the easy basket.
Here comes that trap. Winners with the short jumper.
Winners with the baseline jumper, bottom of the net.
Yeah, a young man here at his size, just a tremendous shooter. And we see it on display right there.
Big guy, Harney, steps outside, knocks down the three ball.
I tell you, Harney's coming into the game, made an impact here. That's his eighth point of the game.
Yeah, he's really been a factor. Winners fell down on the defensive end. Left him wide open. So Fairmont getting a little excited over there, trying to make a run. Down 11. Goddard with a spin move. Nice look, and beautiful assist for the freshman, Drake Goddard. Timmy Goff with easy hoop.
Wow, splits the double team, and here's Harney again.
Harney is red hot. Harney's going to put the Falcons on his back and try to bring them all the way back.
Yeah, Harney with 11 points now off the bench.
Yeah, Harney's been red hot there, 11 points, but Cardinals still with a 10-point advantage. Just need to settle down and get it done here on the offensive end. Fritz will say, there's a three ball.
Fritz answers just like that.
Cardinal coaching staff extremely.
Sick comes midway into the floor.
Yeah, Danny's down in his defensive staff.
he's imploring his defenders.
So Morris with the basketball, keeping an eye on zero. Nice assist. Nick Carney, who's been red hot, way up top at the top of the key, enters it all the way into the basket area. So we'll take another break. Cardinals on top by 13.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
At Wheeling Jesuit, you're watching the Cardinal Cast. Cardinals on top of a fine Fairmont team, 38-25, as we just passed the last media timeout of half number one. And some very impressive things from the Cardinals here tonight, Reese.
Cardinals look good so far, shooting the ball very well. And we see Fairmont making a run here. And
yeah, Nick Harney, what a story.
Yeah, Rich was able to answer with the three here to kind of calm that down a little bit, but Wheeling got to hold on. You don't want to see this slip out of double digits here before the half.
So Caleb Davis will be at the charity stripe for the Falcons.
Davis is one
more. Misses.
Well off the mark on the first one.
This is a pair.
Yeah, long rebound, Harney.
Harney loses it.
And loses it out to the three-point line. And
yeah, Morris, the recipient.
So 4:42, running clock. Fairmont back to within 10.
Seifert in the post. I'm going to call it travel. Yeah, stumbled there. I think he stepped on the defender's foot.
Yeah.
Had pretty good position, just couldn't get himself set.
So 4:20 as the clock rolls.
Stay up on this guy.
Absolutely. You can't give zero any room. Morris going to try another three.
Tipped away by Highsmith. Moss is going to give Gooder a break.
Morris with a nice look in.
And oh, nice block
great
by Seifert.
Defense, perfect. Seifert.
Cool.
That's tough. That's tough. Cardinals, nice hustle play.
Who is that referee?
I thought he made a great call. Of course, that's my good buddy, Reese. I can't say anything about him.
He's lucky there's not something in his bottle. Weigh it down, I throw it at him. Well, heck of a block by Seifert down on the block there.
Unbelievable.
We'll let that one go by.
Super rejection.
Yeah, well, it looked like an easy layup.
Jamal Morris in the lane and
nice D by Highsmith.
Nice hands by Highsmith. Shot clock ticking down. I'm not sure Fairmont's aware of it.
Harney almost came
away.
I'll
tell you, every rebound's a battle in that. Fritz couldn't get to the pass.
Yeah, couldn't get that initial touch on it and got by him.
Every time the ball goes up on the glass, Reese, it is a battle royale.
Oh, yeah, Fairmont's going after it. Neither team scored in almost 2 minutes now. It's the longest stretch we've had in this game. There's Highsmith.
Yeah, here. Nice job of Highsmith staying on the glass.
You know, the worst part, he's got Fritz in the corner there with his feet set, ready to go.
Yep. So 2:51 on the stationary clock. Cardinals have led throughout. Actually, 18-point advantage. Was that the biggest, 22-4?
Yeah, 18-point advantage with about 13 minutes to go in the first half. So some 10, 11 minutes ago.
Yeah, scoring pace obviously has slowed.
Yeah, you said it. We're only shooting 40% from the field, 50% from the field. So shooting the ball well, just they made them all up front.
Nick Harney came in averaging 13, and I believe he's
at 13 now.
He's at his average right now, yeah. Been impressive here in first half action.
So now down to an 8-point lead. Let's see how Wheeling responds.
Seifert
That's not a bad response right there.
Absolutely. 31, Seaford for two. Nice job by Eric controlling the basketball.
Oh. Seaford now, his second foul, kind of a cheap one from the back.
Yeah. It doesn't matter whether it was a shooting foul or not. It's going to be two shots.
Yep.
Cardinals now with 10 fouls.
At the line, number three, Morgan.
Thought that might have been a pass, but it's a moot issue at this juncture.
Yeah.
So exactly 2 minutes remaining in first half action here at the McDonough Center. Cardinals with a 10-point advantage. Chase Morgan, the lefty, with the first one. Chase Morgan from Pineville, West Virginia.
Pineville.
You familiar with that, Reese?
Oh, I've been to Pineville several times.
Okay. Little running back, played for Penn State. Wasn't too shabby in his day. And I'm going to show you how old I am. I can't think of his name. Warner.
Kurt Warner?
That's terrible.
Pineville. My old roommate lived there. In fact, I was down in Beckley, stayed with him a few weeks ago.
There you go.
So I used to go down and visit his family.
Small world, huh?
Oh, Pondville's a small world, yes. Here's Goff in the corner, going to get
Goff
the three.
Reigns a nice looking free ball. Cardinals back on top by double digits.
Tim Goff extending the court this year with the 3-point shot.
So Vega on the bounce.
Can't leave the shooter. Goff, nice body there, nice block out, gets the rebound.
Fritz, what a nice job. Oh, Timmy.
Tim Goff just
Goff wasn't aware.
Tried to get out of the way.
Yep. So Vega's going
to
reset the offense.
Half,
we're in the final 40 seconds of half number one here.
Nice defense.
And we're going to have a timeout for the Cardinals.
Sancombe wants to plan it out.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Late in first half action here. Only 32 seconds remaining on the clock. Cardinal basketball and what's certainly been an entertaining first half, Reese.
Yeah, I tell you what, you know, we on Jesuit came out early hot and established a lead, and Fairmont, who couldn't make a bucket, couldn't buy a bucket early on, has fought their way back now in an 11-point game right now.
A lot of it on the shoulders of Nick Harney.
Nick Harney coming off the bench with 13 points really provided that spark Fairmont needed to get back in this game.
I think if you're Jesuit right now, you're definitely looking to run the shot clock down, and Fairmont doing their best to put some pressure on. Oh, turnover.
Yeah, just too easy. And Harney's going to
cap
it off.
Harney, four.
Now with 5 seconds, Lawson going to look to get the last shot up here. No, he didn't get it off.
Fritz did not get the effort off. So we go to the halftime. Wheeling Jesuit 43, Fairmont State 34, and don't wait, folks. It's going to be a great second half.
Well, I tell you what, if Fairmont continues to play like they did the last 10 minutes of this first half, Wheeling Jesuit's going to have to bring their A game the second half to maintain this lead.
Yeah, game the Cardinals led 22-4 early, but Fairmont has certainly fought their way back in this one. So let's go to our halftime break. We'll be back in 12 minutes. You're watching Wheeling Jesuit University basketball on the Cardinal Cast.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Great location, history, workforce, innovation. Is that what you think of when you hear the words Wheeling, West Virginia? Well, here's the real legacy of Wheeling. We were the first gateway to the West. We became a hub of the Industrial Revolution. We helped build the steel industry on our river, the coal industry in our hills. We became a haven for business innovation and some of the wealthiest business developers on the planet. Wheeling, West Virginia helped move the country forward. And what about now? There's a new Wheeling, one that's inviting to new and growing companies and creating jobs. It's a whole new approach, an innovative transition from an industrial-centered economy to one that brings together the best in low-overhead economic development, one that's attracting businesses with a global reach, creating new offices out of structures long forgotten, building a new energy sector revolution, and a thriving high-tech hub. A city that has turned a declining riverfront into a vibrant landmark. Building resorts and parks on iconic areas while maintaining historic integrity. Developing empty hillsides, lots, and fields into retail, educational, and healthcare destinations. Reducing tax burdens. Nurturing both small and large businesses. Once again, Wheeling is innovating, transforming, and most of all, inviting the world to live, work, and play in one of the safest cities in the U.S. What is it about this Wheeling metro area that's so inviting? Take a moment and explore. Wheeling does offer a pro-business environment, but also a pleasing blend of history, culture, fine dining. Metropolitan features found both here and in our neighboring cities. Outdoor recreation, and annual festivals, all guaranteed to provide you with true American hospitality. Wheeling is a riverfront city where the bluegrass meets jazz, blues, rock, and our own symphony. We are the heart of a vibrant metropolitan tri-state area with neighboring Ohio and Pennsylvania, a region of over more than 200,000 people, making us culturally alive and diverse. Located on the I-70 corridor between Pittsburgh and Columbus, Wheeling is home to a safe, comfortable lifestyle with big city amenities not found in most small towns, including Broadway shows and the historic Capitol Theater. That's why so many are saying we offer more. More accessibility, more centralized.
over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Great location, history, workforce, innovation. Is that what you think of when you hear the words Wheeling, West Virginia? Well, here's the real legacy of Wheeling. We were the first gateway to the West. We became a hub of the Industrial Revolution. We helped build the steel industry on our river, the coal industry in our hills. We became a haven for business innovation and some of the wealthiest business developers on the planet. Wheeling, West Virginia helped move the country forward. And what about now? There's a new Wheeling, one that's inviting to new and growing companies and creating jobs. It's a whole new approach, an innovative transition from an industrial-centered economy to one that brings together the best in low-overhead economic development, one that's attracting businesses with a global reach, creating new offices out of structures long forgotten, building a new energy sector revolution, and a thriving high-tech hub. A city that has turned a declining riverfront into a vibrant landmark. Building resorts and parks on iconic areas while maintaining historic integrity. Developing empty hillsides, lots, and fields into retail, educational, and healthcare destinations. Reducing tax burdens, nurturing both small and large businesses. Once again, Wheeling is innovating, transforming, and most of all, inviting the world to live, work, and play in one of the safest cities in the U.S. What is it about this Wheeling metro area that's so inviting? Take a moment and explore. Wheeling does offer a pro-business environment, but also a pleasing blend of history, culture, fine dining, metropolitan features found both here and in our neighboring cities, outdoor recreation, and annual festivals, all guaranteed to provide you with true American hospitality. Wheeling is a riverfront city where the bluegrass meets jazz, blues, rock, and our own symphony. We are the heart of a vibrant metropolitan tri-state area with neighboring Ohio and Pennsylvania, a region of over more than 200,000 people, making us culturally alive and diverse. Located on the I-70 corridor between Pittsburgh and Columbus, Wheeling is home to a safe, comfortable lifestyle with big city amenities not found in most small towns, including Broadway shows and the historic Capitol Theater. That's why so many are saying we offer more accessibility, more centralized location, more cost savings for business, more fun with museums, shopping, nightlife, and a huge music scene. More restaurants, offering everything from our own brand of fish and our own style of pizza, to great local eateries and fine gourmet dining. More development and growth, a revitalized riverfront, unique shopping at our center market, and the Highlands. State-of-the-art government buildings, global operations centers, casinos, resorts, more technology, more excellent schools. More excellent healthcare, more sports, like our own pro hockey team, the Wheeling Nailers, and a short ride to the Pittsburgh Steelers, Penguins, and Pirates. And to top it off, Wheeling is more appealing, recognized as one of the most livable small metros in the country. It all adds up to an energetic and welcoming city. Modern, progressive, and moving forward again. So now you know. Go ahead, enjoy the Wheeling Metro. Move yourself or a business here. Find a site and start or grow a company here. Explore our excellent funding sources and tax incentives. Learn about our business resources and live in the comfort, safety, and low-cost environment right here in the center of America. Wheeling, a city that's growing, transforming, innovating, inviting, and a city dedicated to making things happen for you. I'm John Corbett, and Wheeling is the place I call home.
there are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
No, for a while we're not.
Back at Wheeling Jesuits halftime. Cardinals on top, 43-34, and some real positives on the stat sheet, Reese.
Boy, Wheeling Jesuit, yeah, with a strong shooting first half, 54% from the field, 12-22, 45% behind the line. Remember, that included 3-for-3 to start the game, which really jump-started the offense in the game for Wheeling Jesuit.
There's a big item there, 14-18 from the charity stripe. That's a lot of tosses in the first half.
That's sure. You know, right behind them, Fairmont at 8-12. So,
yeah.
lot of fouls in that first half. Both teams in the double bonus.
One thing
Fairmont very early.
Rebounds. Cardinals on top, 21-13.
So. Yeah, doing a great job. Fairmont just gets a lot of touches on the ball.
Yes.
They get a lot of tips, and they really make you work for it, as you said. I think the story of the game, quite frankly, Nick Harney coming off the bench for Fairmont with 15 points.
Yeah.
Wheeling was on the verge of putting this thing away, and all of a sudden, Harney gets hot. Gets a couple threes, gets fouled, a couple free throws,
yeah.
And really gave a spark to Fairmont.
Harney actually led him in minutes. He played 18 minutes. So
he had plenty of opportunity,
yeah,
right?
If he doesn't show up.
And they're going to keep him on the floor to start the first half, and I'd say that's a good decision.
Yeah, Harney.
Now, the other thing, you know, Seifert and Kyle Ritz back on the floor, both with a pair of fouls for Wheeling Jesuits, so they spent a little time on the bench.
So we're back to second half action. Seifert going to take it all the way in. And
there's those two guys making an impact early.
Didn't get the results, but both of them make their presence felt here early. Davis attacks the hoop, and who else? Nick Harney with the tap.
Nick Harney. He came to Wheeling to have the game of his life. He said, if I'm going to run around on a bus in the cold, I might as well make something out of it.
Yeah, he's now 7-of-9 from the field, and he's above his average.
Boy, dangerous pass in a backcourt.
And we're going to have a backcourt.
Justin Fritz going to argue that he wasn't established, but once again, that guy, what's that referee? That's two calls I'm going to have to ask him about.
If you've noticed, both times Fritz has looked at the referee and acknowledged the call. I know you're not willing to accept that.
That's a mistake on Fritz's part. I'll have to talk to him after the game, too.
I know you're not willing to accept that, though. Pull up in the lane, and Morris.
Four quick points for Fairmont.
Yeah.
And it's a five-point ball game here.
Fairmont coming with the press.
Yeah, his pressure is.
Jesuit, nice job of centering it. Timmy Goff and Kyle Ritz is fouled in the act.
Yes, he certainly is.
Now they got Wimbush. I know he had two early, so.
Who was it on?
That's his on third. Two. It
is indeed. Good eyes.
Thomas Wimbush picks up his third.
Team first.
So Kyle Ritz at the charity stripe.
Ritz.
Oh.
Ritz will shoot one more.
That looks like a free throw shot by a guy who sat for about 14 minutes with two fouls.
Gets the second one. So early second half, Cardinals lead by six. The Fairmont Falcons in town tonight.
Yeah, if the Cardinals thought it was going to be easy after when they were leading by 18, they got a surprise here from Fairmont. Going to have to work for it the rest of the way.
Morris from deep in the corner and tip back out. Morris will control the rebound.
Arnie calling for the ball aggressively over here.
Just go by memory, which is always so correct. It seems like these Fairmont games are always battles, Race.
Yeah. You know, good program like that, they're not going to go away. And they're proving it here. They've got good players. They got off to a slow start tonight, but these guys know how to play this game.
So Fairmont back to within four.
Time out. Come on.
Kyle Ritz loses the handle, and Ritz.
Bodies are flying. And
yeah, there's some bumping going on.
Ball's flying around. Sandcombe's going nuts.
Yeah. Sandcombe is coming unglued.
He's got to control himself here. Just a four-point game.
Davis, Wimbush going to down.
It's a one-point game here.
Three ball by Wimbush. So what was once an 18-point Cardinal advantage, now down to one. And for Cardinals, you're just looking to get your composure back right now.
Yeah, I'd say it.
A 10-second backcourt violation doesn't help.
Right now, Wheeling Jesuit's got a little bit of that stargaze look in their eyes. They've been, Fairmont's come out and punched them right in the nose here in the first half, in the second half here to start. Fairmont with what, an 11-2 run to start this half?
Great opening. Be out of bounds, the Cardinals.
And this press, it was Wheeling was getting a lot of easy shots off in the first half. All of a sudden, has really tightened up and is creating some problems. And the travel, absolutely, he did.
Sometimes the game just seems surreal, Reese. I think I looked up that shot clock. It was on 24. Is that possible? That was also a violation?
No, he walked. It was a travel.
No, he walked, but I'm just saying, is it possible it could have been 11 seconds, or was that clock just not reset?
I think that clock just didn't reset right.
Yeah, I hear
you. There's no way it was that long. But,
I didn't think so.
But definitely a travel. And Fairmont is on the attack right now. Somebody get the ball.
Yeah,
great block out. Somebody go get the ball.
Had a great block out.
And here, even off the miss, Fairmont going to attack with the pressure.
If you're Jesuit, you just need to. There you go. Fritz gets to the basket. Timmy Goff with a putback.
Stop the bleeding a little bit, right?
Just a little bit. Thank goodness. Finally get a hoop there. Somebody needs to guard this young man. Harney has been ultra impressive since midway through the first half. Jamel Morris controls up top.
Great rebound. Tim Goff
getting very active on the glass.
Yeah, just doesn't make a good decision on a run, though. Yeah. Got to give it up.
And a real high dribble there. Not exactly sure why, but.
My guess is the coach is telling us why. Pass the ball. That'd be like me dribbling down the court.
Exactly.
Nobody has to get in the way for me to dribble it over my head.
And Wimbush will be rewarded with a seat on the bench.
Highsmith going to check into the game here.
So Drake Goddard will take over the point guard duties here. And we're going to have a hold out front. Morris going to be called for the hand check.
Foul number 21, Morris.
So 15:34 on the stop clock. Fairmont has come all the way back, and we're in for a dogfight here tonight.
Oh, that was a slap that he got away with in that double team.
Absolutely.
Number 21, Morris for two.
So Morris makes it a one-point game. Here comes Wheeling on the attack.
Fritz up top, still 20 seconds on the shot clock. Highsmith going to take it in, and
he's going to draw some contact about four different times.
Morris going to whistle for the foul.
Morris will pick up his second. Can we get called it on?
Yep. So we'll head to immediate break. Cardinals on top by one.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Back at the McDonough Center, second half action. We're at the first media break. Cardinals, who once enjoyed an 18-point advantage in the first half, now lead by one.
I'll tell you what, Fairmont with a lot of energy right now, really the aggressor. Really looking for somebody to step forward.
So Haywood Highsmith, the young freshman, going to be at the charity stripe. Haywood will have a pair. Misses a pair. So Fairmont with an opportunity to take the lead. I think they led it to 2-0.
They led 2-0, and that was it. Jesuit went on a
17-0 run.
Yep. And I fought all the way back here, and there it is.
Fairmont has come all the way back. So at the 14:38 mark of half number two, Fairmont now in the lead. Highsmith Fairmont hurries it down the floor. Morris, three ball.
Wow.
Fairmont will take a timeout.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports. There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Back at the McDonough Center, Fairmont came out of a little 5-0 to run coming out of the media timeout, and Coach Calhoun, for some reason, decided to call a timeout and stop the run, which hopefully that works out for Jesuit. I think he wanted to call timeout and tell him how good he was doing recently.
Timeout and tell him, keep it up. Keep up the good work. You got to give him a little positive reinforcement.
So Eric Seifert on the attack.
An easy turnover, but going to be called for the travel here.
Fortunately, Cardinals threw it away.
Really gets a heck of a break.
Fairmont said they didn't want the basketball. They'll give it right back to us. Seifert.
And again, turns it over. These guys are just too long and quick for that passing angle. You've got to take a dribble at them.
They're certainly sitting in the passing lanes. So Fairmont with a four-point advantage, their biggest lead of the evening. Looking to add to it.
Morris, step back, knocks down a three.
So Morris has had a couple big, long.
Morris now with 18.
Jake Lawson, three ball.
Well, great work by Kyle Ritz inside.
Yeah, Ritz staying on the board, and he's going to be fouled.
The only good news is that's 15 foul already on Fairmont.
Yeah, Fairmont once again in that fouling mode. It's a third foul on the big guy, Nick Carney.
And one.
Going to get the basket and some arm.
Matt Stewart just into the game.
Yeah, nice turnaround move by the sophomore.
You know, that's what Matt can do for us, right? Matt is a true inside scorer, can put the ball on the deck, and it's great to see his presence back in the game.
So, well, Morris picks up personal foul number three. Chase Morgan going to check in the Fairmont lineup. So it was actually a 7-point Fairmont advantage.
Reeling will be in the bonus from here on out.
Morris. Wimbush, long distance. And
how about that rebound?
Stewart, nice job of holding his ground.
Ahead to Fritz. Seifert open in the corner for three. Yes.
Three ball, Eric Seifert. So the Cardinals back within two. Fairmont, Wimbush up top. Caleb Davis looking for some driving room. Fairmont reset, plenty of time on the shot clock, ticking down to 10.
After Mark, great box out by Stewart, and Seifert comes out with a rebound.
Seifert, a nice rebounding effort there.
Oh.
Yeah. Only you like that shot, Reese.
Just take that right back and try it again. Still a lot of time on the shot clock.
Goddard going to take it in, but can't get to the hoop.
Kind of got himself. He made a nice pump fake and move. Unfortunately, he was under the bucket, had nowhere to go.
Well, was trying to operate up top for the Fairmont.
Sorry, dribbled it out of bounds. I saw it.
Cardinals possession.
So Cardinals with the basketball, trailing by two. We passed the 11-minute mark of half number two. Goddard, a little room to operate, foul line jumper.
Ooh.
And Harney.
Not the shot we were looking rebound. For there.
So Fairmont going to reset the offense. Morris wide open.
Morris feeling it here in the second half.
Yeah, nice ball move there. Harney had it in a low post, but kicked it back out for the three.
Can't go north and south here, boys. Got to get up the floor.
Fritz.
The attack, throws it away.
So it's a five-point Fairmont lead. We are approaching the midway point of half number two. Kyle Ritz will return to the Cardinal lineup.
Well, I'll tell you what, just when Harney cooled off at 17 points, Jamal Morris steps up now 21, yeah. And he is feeling it here in the second half.
Yep. Two-prong attack here tonight for the Falcons.
He gets Stewart to push low.
Only the first foul in the Cardinals this half, and we'll go to our second media timeout.
Timeout.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
At Wheeling Jesuit, Tom Barbeck along with John Respect, Fairmont State Falcons in town, and they've certainly brought their A game since the midway point of half number one.
Boy, they sure have been on a heck of a run. And you know, an interesting stat that jumps out at me here: field goals taken. Wheeling Jesuit has taken 33 shots. Fairmont has taken 47 shots. That's a heck of a difference right there. Shooting roughly the same percentage, Fairmont at 42, Wheeling Jesuit at 45, but boy, that's a lot of attempts.
One stat that skews that a little bit is in the first half, Cardinals did have more free throw attempts, although
they did.
Fairmont had their fair share, too.
Right. Yeah. I think this second half, we've seen the full court pressure really have its effect.
So we're under the 10-minute mark, half number two. Godwell is number four, going to handle the basketball. He'll try a three. A rebound pulled down by Lawson. Oh, my goodness.
Lawson.
And those ones kill you, those unforced errors, Reese.
No doubt. Lawson threw that one. If it wasn't for that back wall, it'd still be fine.
So Fairmont, 5-point lead and the basketball. We approach the 9-minute mark of first half or second half action. Morris
again, another dagger.
You cannot leave him. He is red hot. And like I said, Cardinals just having a hard time with his press.
Timeout.
Danny Sankum, you need to get a timeout.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
So back to action. Cardinals having a tough time handling the press. Nice effort this time.
A nice catch by Goddard. Tough pass there. The little bounce pass on the run.
So Cardinals get it to back within eight. Right now, you really just need to find two guys. Number zero, number 21.
Yeah, no kidding. Those two guys have been lighting it up here. Morris has had a heck of a second half now with 24 points. Clearing it out for Harney.
That's a pretty nice offensive move.
Zero, Harney for two.
And all of a sudden, they're going to pull it back.
Yeah. Interesting decision.
Seifert,
three ball.
Mark, Goddard comes out. Oh.
So Fairmont willing to run a little time off the clock now. Going to play a little cat and mouse here with the Cardinals. Leading by 10 points as we approach the 7-minute mark. Deep three from Morris.
Oh, come on.
Say goodnight.
Wow.
From the G in Wheeling Jesuit, he he knocks it down, and I never like to exaggerate, but that's close to 30 feet.
That was that's a guy who is just feeling it right now.
Yeah. Thing I like about him too, Reese, he lets the game come to him. He
doesn't force
the action.
Yeah, he's not forcing, right. He's taking it off, you know, off the offense.
Foul on number two, Wimbush is fourth, team seventh.
Yeah, that was ridiculously long. So it's a 13-point Fairmont advantage in a game that Fairmont appears to have in control right now. What's amazing is when you look at the numbers, they have doubled us up 62 to 31 over the last, or 32, whatever it is, over the last 15 minutes.
Yep.
25 minutes, excuse me.
Right here, the free throw line may be the one thing that could save us here in the bonus. 7 minutes left, and here comes some pressure.
Yep. Sam Godwell over the top to Davis. Said Fairmont certainly willing to run some clock now.
Really in this 2-3 zone here. Aiden just off the mark. Wow.
Andrew Evans went up to get that rebound.
Saves it, and they're going to run it back out again.
Fairmont certainly willing to eat up some valuable clock time.
Aiden off the mark, hit from behind. Reeling ball.
So 5:35, clock stops. Jesuit still trailing by 11.
That is unbelievable. What a change
from
the first half, first 10 minutes of this game.
Two different games. Lawson, three ball.
Off the mark.
What's the rebound stat right now, Reese?
You know, Wheeling is still leading 32-35. Or 25, I mean, rebounding edge. But
season of the second half, Fairmont certainly has the ones that counted.
Yeah, they sure have. You know, Will and Jesuit had that early advantage shooting threes. They're now 6 of 15 from the three-point line. Fairmont 10 of 22. So Fairmont has got red hot behind the line, and that's not going to count.
So only the second team foul on Cardinals, so it'll be Fairmont out of bounds when we return.
His second, team second, timeout.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
.47 remaining in this one. Cardinals trail 66-55, and second half's been a Jamal Morris show.
And Jamal Morris just gone crazy here, 27 points now at the game. After six in the first half,
yeah,
so 21
say,
here in the second half.
Just checking the stat sheet, only six at halftime, but
yeah.
He certainly made up for lost time in the second half. Once again, just really need up some of that clock.
Yeah, just stand there, pound it, and let it run away. Getting inside off the mark. Fairmont gets a hand, but Fritz comes out with the loose ball.
Greg Goddard hurries it down the floor. Nice look inside. Calvert's going to be fouled.
So again, an opportunity to step the line, cut into this lead with the clock stopped.
Foul number 24, Andrew Evans, his third teammate at the line, number 25, Rich. Rich will shoot two.
So Cal gets the first.
Off on the second, quick trap by Jesuit. So an even 10 points here with 4 minutes left.
Fritz will pick up the foul. That foul just gives him 35 more seconds.
Right, just reset the shot clock. Seifert gets a hand, loose ball. Morris comes away and gets the easy bucket.
Two for number 21, Morris.
Huge night for Jamel Morris. Came in averaging 15. He's going to double that tonight. Nice hustle by Highsmith. He'll get the easy put back.
Two for
so Cardinals back to within 10, 3:27, and we'll take a timeout.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
3:27 as the clock starts to roll. Fairmont on top by 10. Jesuit needs to come up with a steal.
You know, with just three team fouls.
Yeah, the problem is you almost hurt yourself when you foul.
Right. There's one there that's going to reset the clock, give them an extra 15 seconds.
So only the fourth team foul. Goddard picks up his first. 3:11.
Smith gets a hand on it. I got to tell you, when this one holds up this way, Coach Sanko, I'm not going to sleep well tonight thinking about this one.
A game with an extremely strong start, but it's been all Fairmont from that juncture.
And again, loose balls just all going to Fairmont right now.
Still 20 seconds on the shot clock, so Fairmont eating up a valuable minute of time on this possessions, if you will. Morris, little trip down the lane. Seifert comes out with it.
His first miss in some time. Goddard gets the three.
That's Chris Canteen.
Oh, Canteen. No,
I think it's Cantine, but we're going to get a correction on that. Yeah, but no
so
problem.
So used to Goddard running that wing here.
Absolutely. And Chris is going to pick up the foul.
Not just five team fouls.
Yeah, only the 15th foul. And Coach Calhoun's going to get a timeout for Fairmont.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
So that was the second foul on Chris Cantine. Apparently some issue with the scoring table. Well, we had some issues apparently with the scoreboard. Numbers are back up now.
There we go.
Disappeared momentarily.
That's not a bad thing. Yep. Sankholm just pulled the plug.
So fresh shot clock for Fairmont, who has elected the milk clock. Cantine with a nice deflection, but Fairmont controls.
Oh, nice,
nice rejection by Kyle Ritz. Trigger it in. And Morris. Seifert bumps Morris. Only the sixth foul, so Fairmont will not be shooting.
And in that case, just a nice pump fake by Morris that really drew that contact. Unfortunately, it reset on the shot clock. Now you got a foul. Put him at the line.
Yep.
Like that foul right there.
Yeah, Fairmont's going to come out and they're going to milk it.
Somebody go get him right there, Highsmith. Get him.
Still 15 on the shot clock, and we're going to have a timeout for Fairmont.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Seconds on the shot clock.
He's been defending hard up front here.
Cardinals forced a turnover.
Yes, sir. It's a big turnover. It took a lot of time, but it's a big turnover here.
Good possession. Good turnover for the Cardinals.
Just a seven-point game. Let's see what Wheeling can do here on this possession.
Need to get a score on this possession. Three ball.
Off to the left.
Can't time.
Now you got to attack hard. Central calling for the foul. We're backing off. Somebody's got to come up.
Oh, that's a foul.
Nothing wrong with that. You're going to put him at the line, make him a little shaky.
So Shamgod Wells is going to walk the charity stripe. So 1:16 on the stationary clock. 7-point Fairmont advantage.
Wells doesn't have a point here tonight. Now a 9-point game. You got to get a shot.
Kyle Ritz attacks the basket, and
Mark,
one of those nice reads. That one wouldn't go in.
Possession to Fairmont.
So we're under a minute. It's a 9-point Fairmont advantage. Cardinals going to need some help here. Fairmont's going to have to contribute. Desi Wiseman, number 20, going to check in for the Cardinals along with Chris Cantine.
The reeling ball back down here.
90-foot pass, and Fairmont player went out the exit door.
Wimbush headed for the bus.
So Wiseman and Cantine did their job.
They sure did.
Cardinals going to put the offensive team back in.
So much like the ladies' game, Wheeling Jesuit, a big lead early. Faltering here down the stretch.
Yep. We got a momentarily stop in the action while we're doing a little housekeeping at the scorer's table.
Oh, okay. They cannot sub because the clock never started.
Yeah, good. Reach right on top of that, buddy. I'm impressed with your rules knowledge.
Huh? Oh, I know them. I just don't like to follow them. You know, speaking of that, you know, there was an incident Friday night. Doug Costain had to come out of the bleachers and help make a call.
Yeah.
One of the games. You here?
Yeah, I was here.
Boy, that was something else. I thought I was going to have to yell something. They were going to give him four free throws on the ball. That's a heck of a turnover.
Unheard of, Reese. Fritz, three ball.
Yes. There it is.
So back to within six, 57.7.
Big possession right here.
Cardinals still a glimmer of hope. Need to force something on the defensive end here. Morris.
Come and get him. Got to come and get him. There it is.
We're going to have the bump, and Chase Morgan going to walk the line. I'll tell you, Calhoun and Sanko, two of the more animated coaches.
They're working harder than any players out there.
Yeah, I guarantee you those two guys are going to need showers after this one's over.
At the line, number three, Morgan.
Tell you, I don't know Jared Calhoun from Adam, but you got to like his demeanor on the sideline. He's always encouraging his kids.
And I'll tell you got to like the way his team plays for you. They never quit. They were down early.
Yep.
Couldn't make anything happen, and boy, a big break there.
So the Cardinals with the basketball down six. Seifert three ball.
Nope.
Couldn't get
somebody's
that one.
He's got to be in there for that rebound.
Morris is quickly fouled.
Man, somebody was. Morris. You know, we get a break there. Morgan, who had been 4-for-4 from the line, misses and can't cap it.
Morris has been the story, certainly, of this second half. How many points do you have, Reese?
29.
29 points, Jamel Morris.
1-1 here, a chance to get himself to 30 and extend this lead.
Crawls it in. So he's doubled his average, came in 15 points per game. 30 here tonight.
You go on the road in the MEC, somebody's got to step up, and tonight Morris and Harney were the two guys stepping up for Fairmont. Got to go quick.
And Mark's not going to get it done. Quick foul.
Quick foul after a quick turnover is not a good recipe.
Definitely not.
Double bonus.
So Caleb Davis will step to the charity stripe. This is the first.
Well, they're trying to let us in it, but we're not doing much on the other side.
So they miss a pair. Cardinals need to hurry. Goddard's going to take it all the way. Ritz with easy putback. Timeout, Cardinals. We'll stay right here, Reese. 22.7 seconds remaining, and as long as there's time on the clock, you're still alive. But
you're looking for
need a steal or
an adrenaline shot here. You know, at this point, unfortunately, had a couple chances there. Had a chance with the game at 6 points and couldn't convert.
Yeah, Seaford had a pretty good look from three. If that one falls, you know, but. If ifs and nuts, as they always say.
Yeah, so unfortunately sitting here down six with 22 seconds left and, a timeout there to get your defensive substitutions in. Can't get the quick steal, you foul.
So the Cardinal is going to win. Make one last effort here. 22.7 seconds. Trail by six. Push off by Morris, not called. Wiseman does a good job deflecting it back out of bounds.
How did it end up throwing my ball? It looked to me like he just threw it out of bounds.
And Coach Calhoun's going to get a timeout, so the chess match will continue.
I don't want you going home and going to bed early.
Now, you expect anything different. These two coaches have been working their tails off all night long, and neither one of them are going to get down easily, I can tell you that. So 21.7 seconds remaining. Coach Sandcombe imploring his troops. Try to make something happen here in the final seconds. And of course, folks, we want to remind you, the Cardinal men will be back in action Saturday afternoon at 4 o'clock when the Pioneers of Glenville State come to town. And I think, Reese, I think they're sitting in the number two spot in the conference. So
yeah, 10-2 Glenville State, a quality club coming into town here on Saturday.
Yeah, going to be another big challenge on Saturday afternoon. Of course, anytime you tee it up in the Mountain East Conference, you're usually facing a pretty formidable opponent. Just a quality league. And Wiseman is going to get the quick foul.
Morris going to go to the line.
So Jamil Morris will take his 30 points and step to the charity stripe.
Final number 20, Wiseman, this second. Morris.
So Jamil Morris with his second attempt. puts Fairmont up 8 points.
Bain extends his game high to 32 points.
Clock rapidly running down. Fritz.
Fritz going to lose it, turn it over. So I'm not even sure Fritz could have possession there. Wouldn't that be backcourt?
Could have been. I think it's academic at this point.
I understand.
So the held ball, the arrow is going to go to the Cardinals.
Cardinal possession. Timeout.
Seriously, Danny. I sometimes think these coaches get paid by the hour.
Yeah. I think that's just, did Danny call that timeout?
I don't know.
I think it's just a matter of trying to finish this out, this game out in a classical manner. I think that's all.
Yeah.
Just remind the kids. Got a little, not too testy, but just a little testy there after that play.
Yeah, they did.
Fairmont kids kind of razzing some of our players, so. You always like to see games end on a good note. 8 points down, 8 seconds to go. There's not a whole lot of coaching you can do.
A lot of strategy behind this one.
Fritz, three ball, yes.
Rolls it in from the corner.
So it's down to five, but only 4 seconds remaining, and save that foul for Saturday.
Yeah, Goddard going to be called with the grab.
Yeah. Only 3 seconds remaining.
At the line, number 30, Davis.
So Caleb Davis at the line, 6'1", sophomore for Fairmont. He'll get a pair.
Quickly. Highsmith at the buzzer.
So Highsmith at the buzzer. Final score. Fairmont State 75, winning Jesuit 69. Fairmont goes to 8-5 on the campaign, 5-2 in the Mountain East Conference. Jesuit goes to 6-5, 2-4 in the conference, and
tough one to lose, Reese. You know, when you're up 18 in the midway through the first half and feels like everything's going your direction, and credit Fairmont State, never gave up. Nick Harney with a big first half, finishes the game with 19, was really that spark that got Fairmont going, and in the second half, Jamal Morris just picked up the load and took off with 33 points.
Yeah, and it's all about a game about numbers. They outscored us 71-47 over that last 30 minutes, if you will. So Cardinals with a tough loss here. Not much time to regroup and lick your wounds, Reese.
Yeah, great Glenville team coming into town here on Saturday. They've been on a heck of a roll. Wheeling now dropped two in a row here in the conference. So got to really step forward here on Saturday, regroup, and get themselves ready to play.
So that's pretty much the story here tonight from the McDonough Center. Cardinals with a tough loss. Started real strong, 18-point advantage. We're going to wrap it up. On behalf of Don Watson, John Riesbeck, Tom Bear-Bechtel, good night and God bless.